A 71-year-old man has become the latest person to be arrested as part of Scotland Yard's investigation into phone hacking. He's understood to be Stuart Cutner, the former managing editor of the News of the World. He's the 11th person to be arrested since police began their latest investigation in January. Our correspondent, Matt Prodger, is at Scotland Yard. Matt.
George Bellier, a day goes by without another development in the phone hacking investigation at the moment. Today it was Stuart Cutner, a veteran of 22 years service at the News of the World when he left the paper in 2009 as managing editor. We understand he presented himself at a police station this morning and that police are still questioning him this evening.
First things first.
This is Stuart Cutner back in 2009, telling MPs he may have unknowingly approved cash payments in relation to phone hacking.
A relatively small but regrettable number of false cash payments were created and were approved on the whole, not always, but generally by me, unknowing.
He told them his job as managing editor was to bridge the gap between journalists and management at the News of the World. Stuart Cutner was a high-profile figure at the newspaper. Here he is 10 years ago with the family of murdered schoolgirl Sarah Payne, campaigning for a law to name and shame paedophiles. Sarah's mother last weekend discovered that she too may have been a victim of phone hacking by the News of the World.
He was once described as the person who came closest to being the DNA of the organisation. He appeared in public relatively frequently, representing the organisation in the case of Sarah's Law. He did that. And critically, as the managing editor, that's where the money goes through.
Day by day, the number of people arrested in connection with phone hacking has increased. Among them, Andy Coulson, who resigned as News of the World editor and as the Prime Minister's Director of Communications. Rebecca Brooks, his predecessor as editor. Neil Wallace, a former deputy editor, and three former journalists. Only Clive Goodman, its former royal correspondent, and investigator Glenn Mulcair have been convicted. This afternoon, police arrived at Stuart Cutner's home in search of evidence for a criminal investigation that is still at its early stages. An investigation into journalists, executives, and even the police themselves.
And Matt, there's been news today, has there not, about the man who tried to chuck a foam pie at Rupert Murdoch during those parliamentary hearings.
That's right. Just at about the same time that Stuart Cutner was arriving at a police station in North London, in Westminster, another man was arriving at court. Jonathan May Bowles, 26 years old, from Berkshire. He had already pleaded guilty to assaulting Rupert Murdoch. Now, if you cast your mind back to last month during the Select Committee proceedings, Jonathan May Bowles, also known as Johnny Marbles, walked to the front of the room, up to the desk where Rupert Murdoch was sitting, and threw a paper plate covered with shaving foam at him. And you'll also remember, of course, that Rupert Murdoch's wife, Wendy Deng, leapt to her feet to defend him. Jonathan May Bowles was sentenced today, 6 weeks in jail. He will actually serve 3 weeks, and the judge said that he had disrupted parliamentary proceedings which were taking place to look into a very serious matter, and that he had shown no respect for the seriousness of that matter. Just a reminder, of course, that though the phone hacking scandal is a story of high drama, it has also had its moments of farce.
All right, Matt, thank you very much. In